News Talk 1400 WOND welcomes you to the Don Williams Show, South Jersey's longest running and most listened to local morning talk show. Voice your opinion now. Call 609-927-1100. Now, here's Don Williams on News Talk 1400 WOND, radio you can depend on.
That you can, and we have with us Dr. Mitchell Hackerman of Pro PT, and we have physical therapy, who's from Cape May and where his office has been and where his facility has been. Doctor, good to see you again. It's been 20 years, you tell me.
It's been between 15 to 20 years, and it's such a pleasure to see you again. This is like a reunion.
That was some time ago. That was at nighttime then I was doing a show, right? Was it night? Then
I can't remember if it was at night or
not. Well, were you here or over, and did you come to Venice Park in Atlantic City?
No, I lived in the area.
And so it must have been here. If it was here, it was like 10 or so, 12 years ago, maybe. I don't know.
Oh, you know what? Maybe that's
when we're having fun.
That's probably more accurate.
Yeah. Well, then, and you just recently opened, and reading some facts here, you say you want to talk about how these corporations and hospitals are hiring doctors and gaining control over the patient population and sort of squeezing the physical therapists out, maybe, and also giving the impression that the patient has to use that service.
Well, I bet most of the people listening today know what's going on out there because it's happening all over the place. A lot of people's physicians are now becoming part of other groups, hospitals or big conglomerates. So what happens is, you know, in the past, you know, you could pretty much trust where you're being sent because the physician, and they still do. There's a lot of really good physicians out there that are still interested in making sure you get quality care. And even at times when they know that somebody does a really good job, I'll get patients anyway from some of these physicians because they know what a good job I do. However, they are strongly being encouraged as employees to refer to, like, for example, a hospital-based system. Or they might have an affiliation with a big corporation, and there's pressure for them to do that. And the patients don't really know this. They go in, and the most common thing I see this with is like with total knee replacements, total hip replacements, and they basically get put into the system. And it's not just with this either. It's with many medical services. People go in, once they have you, they assume now that they've got you for everything else that you need. And what has happened, and I've gotten feedback from my patients, where I've been told that my patient went to their physician, and then they get a call like the next day saying, I'm calling to schedule your physical therapy appointment. And, you know, there's a little bit of high pressure salesmanship going on here. And fortunately, I've built up some loyalty over the years over in Cape May, and people still come to me anyway. But as I understand it, there are big conglomerates moving in everywhere. And they've put some people out of business.
And they, you know, they're opening branches here and there.
Exactly.
As well known.
Exactly. Now, they run their facilities. You have to understand, these are not just your everyday facilities. They are run by people who need to keep the flow moving. So you are going to have business concerns, accounting issues, as they say, bean counter concerns. I'm a private physical therapist owner, so my objective is to please the patient. I'm appealing to the public because when the public comes to me, they're going to see a difference in the way we take care of our patients.
And that difference is, you want to point out, can you give us an example of what that difference might be?
Well, sure. For example, if you come in with a neck or a back problem, I'll address the neck or back problem. But I won't just stop there. I'll evaluate your entire body because there's lots of things that can go wrong. In a lot of facilities, you'll notice that when somebody gets treatment for a particular joint, they sort of focus on that joint until you're done your rehab and that's the end of it. Well, I'm not saying all this happens 100% of the time at places, but I go the extra mile. For example, if somebody is a golfer and they have a weak ankle, that weak ankle can cause weakness in the hip. And if you've got weakness in the hip, it can cause a rotational force in the low back while they're swinging their golf club. And then they start having some low back problems and they're wondering about it. They come into me, I evaluate them, I stabilize their problem in their low back, but then I go back and address all these other issues. And there's a lot of situations where somebody has some weaknesses in areas where their muscles are not functioning properly, you get compensatory mechanisms that have to be addressed.
That's, well, you do the diagnosis and everything.
Well, of course, it's a mechanical diagnosis. For example, you'd be surprised to see someone who is a bodybuilder that comes and you'd think he could do pretty much anything. But when you have him lay on his back and he tries to roll over and he uses just his upper body and lets his legs pretty much dangle, not using them at all, he won't be able to roll over. I mean, not with everybody, of course, but there, you'd be surprised how many people have this weakness this way. And it could happen from an injury, a previous injury. It could happen from many mechanisms which cause that to basically shut off, and they don't recognize their weakness, and they may injure more easily. So I go back, and I evaluate for that. And it's almost like going through the developmental sequences that a child goes through. You have to learn to crawl before you walk, basically. And so we actually take you through I take you through those sequences, and we work on recapturing that motor control, the brain-muscle communication, so that you can better prevent a future occurrence from happening. Now, that's not the only difference. The other differences are we basically have a lot of fun in our facility. It's a very social environment, very amicable environment, and people are free to socialize. I've had complaints from some of my patients who've been in other facilities that says they don't let you talk. They you know, so I'm sorry, you have to go over here.
You know, you can't communicate.
But that's part of the healing environment, to be able to sit together and have some conversation. And the thing is I don't have any time limits for my patients. They can stay as long as they want.
You're not on the clock, in other words. You're there. You're going to take care of them and try to do your utmost to heal them and make them better and get them back to work or play, whatever, exactly, as fast as possible. And if it takes you an extra hour or two.
Oh, that's fine. What's an extra body around for me? I enjoy the company myself. And if you think about it, what's really funny is I read an article about big conglomerate who does something called dayhab or day rehab, and it's funny, I'm reading this, I'm thinking, you know something, I invented this when I opened up my facility in 2008, because basically people can stay in my office all day and I don't kick them out. I believe that a lot of times when you're doing certain activities, the tissues need to recuperate, they need to rest in between activities. So naturally, if I let them stay longer, they can get a lot more out of their therapy. And you know, they do a lot in my facility. Things I do with my hands, specialized techniques. I've got a lot of specialized manual therapy skills I use and things I have to choose from. If one thing doesn't work, I can go try another thing. And there's a lot of independent activities that they do.
Now, if you have any questions for Dr. Mitchell Hackerman, 927-1100, 927-1100, from Pro PT and Rehab. What's PT stand for?
Well, it's physical therapy. The actual name of the company is Professional.
Yeah. It should have dawned on me.
It's Professional Physical Therapy and Rehabilitation.
That's the name of your...
It is, but we call it Pro PT and Rehab for short.
You're in Cape May, where you have been.
North Cape May, that is correct. And unfortunately, have a loyal following out there.
What type of injury do you see more often? Back ailments or people needing rehab after having a new kneecap put in or something?
I see a combination of everything. I see a lot of orthopedic patients. I see Parkinson's. I see people with Parkinson's, various neurologic problems. I would have to say the majority are neck and back, because I do have a lot of specialized equipment for that, like the ATM2, which stands for Active Therapeutic Movement Machine. It's a very unique
one of the latest machines.
Well, it's been around for a while, but surprisingly, not a lot of people have it. I think maybe one other person has it, and they got it because I had it first, and they saw what kind of results I was having, and I was getting patients coming to me. But it's an option. It's a tool. And also, I have the spinal decompression machine, and I do want to say something about spinal decompression. When I got into this area, I was surprised by all the advertising I saw where people were charging like $2,000, $8,000 to use spinal decompression. They claim that it's not paid by your insurance. Spinal decompression is spinal mechanical traction. That's what it is. Decompression is the end result of what you're looking for when you use traction. And it's not great. It's not used for everything. Not everything is going to help everything. That's why I have several options to choose from. So when I have somebody come into my office and I think this will benefit them, I can't imagine saying to them, you know what, you can't afford to pay for it, I'm sorry, you have to leave. I can't imagine doing that. So by word of mouth, by doing the right thing, that has helped my North Cape May office build, and I'm hoping that the same thing happens in Mays Landing. People tell me I'm crazy for starting a new practice in this environment, but I strongly believe when people come to me, they're going to see a difference, and they're going to come to me instead. But it's a matter of getting the word out that, you know, you don't have to go where you're sent. I used to see quite a few total knees and hips. I still get them a lot through word of mouth, but I know I'd be seeing a lot more if there wasn't this sort of conveyor belt care going on out there, where they're just sort of feeding themselves, the patients, for all their services. And they're still doing it today. They're trying to open up everywhere and sort of monopolize the patients.
We'll be right back with Dr. Mitchell Hackerman, Pro PT and Rehab Physical Therapy. If you have questions, 927-1100, we'll take this break.
News Talk 1400 WOND. WOND. Radio.com. Voice your opinion now at 927-1100. The Don Williams Show on News Talk 1400 WOND.
Rebecca in Margate, good morning for Dr. Hackerman.
Yes, I had two questions.
Go right ahead.
One, I was hoping he could describe how that ATM machine works that he had mentioned.
And ATM
also,
two.
I wanted to know if he finds that a lot of patients choose a physical therapist by the proximity to their home, unlike how far they would travel for a doctor of a different modality.
Well, it's funny you should say that, because I actually treated, I can say his name because he's actually given me permission to use him in advertising. Dr. David Rayfield traveled an hour to see me out in North Cape May when I just had that office. I do get people from far and near, so it does make a difference. A lot of people choose a therapy place based on location. And location, really, you know, you don't choose your surgeon based on location. And there's so many things that a physical therapist has to be educated on. You don't treat your physical therapist based on location. If it's worth traveling, you travel. And I do have quite a few people traveling a long distance. As far as the ATM2, that stands for active therapeutic movements. That is a device in which it's like a vertical treatment table, and it has compressive belts. You wrap the belts around your body. Well, the therapist wraps it around your body, and they tighten the belts. Those belts allow to, you're able to manipulate the position of the pelvis until you find a pain-free position. And once you find that position and they're completely pain-free, you have them actively push into a pad. It's an isometric contraction. And what you'll find a lot of times is when you have decreased movement in one direction and you use this device, all of a sudden now, even after the one session, you can move better. Now, the theory is that you are establishing the connection between the brain, communication between the brain and the specific muscles in your spine that for stability. And I've got lots of great theories for lots of things that I do, but you know what? They're all theories. And in the end, what I care is the response that I get. I could debate theories all day with people, but this device, the ATM2, has helped a lot of people where nothing else has helped, but so too has the spinal decompression. What I do want to mention is that it really depends on what your particular problem is. Mm-hmm. You could have an inflammatory process going on, which involves constant pain, which it may vary in intensity, or you may come in with what we call a mechanical pain. Mechanical pain is when you have what's called tissue deformation. Theoretically, it could be a disc being compressed in a particular way that's causing pain. You do something to uncompress it, the pain dissipates, reduces, or goes away. If the pain persists, that could be an inflammatory component. So you could have a combination of these things. There have been times where I put people on the ATM2, and I use it sort of as a diagnostic tool, that if it either doesn't change your pain or it increases your pain, that it shows me that you're not ready for that device is not going to work for you, and your problem, that gives me a variable that tells me it's more likely an acute inflammatory process that is not going to respond at that moment. So I may try a few other things, and then we may actually have to help the inflammatory process along its way, and then once things settle out, then we can proceed with something else. That's why I have so many different areas and methodologies to choose from. So that I cover all my bases basically. And I don't, and as I said, I don't charge for the use of it. This device, along with spinal decompression, have been touted as a device you sell. If you tell the insurance company, if you call the insurance company, like these places, did I mention this on air about the about how a lot of places are advertising this?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So if you call it Traction, the insurance companies will pay for it. They just don't pay that much for it. And a lot of insurances only pay one fee for no matter what you do. The thing is I enjoy people. I enjoy working with them. I enjoy helping them. I do everything possible to help them get out of pain. Time is not an object. If you have pain, I will stay with you until I can get rid of that pain or reduce it, or if I can't do it because the status of your injury is such that I can't affect it. Now, I do want to mention to you that there are times when somebody might say, oh, they had a lot of pain the next day. I try to tell people from the get-go, pain is your guide. It's not there to scare you. It's there to give you information. So when I work with somebody, if for some reason they worsen after a session, they need to communicate with me and let me know that so we can modify the program. That gives me more information so I know where to go next. So don't always assume that because you received the treatment and you didn't get the response you expected that this was the wrong way to go. It gives you more needed information, which directs us in another direction.
Does that answer your question, Rebecca?
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you very much for calling. Jenny, we'll take one more call here. Jenny, good morning.
Hey, good morning. Dr. Eckerman, thank you for taking the call. I have a friend who got a total knee fusion. The doctor in the beginning said that physical therapy was imperative, but from the get-go, he kept suggesting another surgery, which made me somewhat leery. I've been working in nursing, it seems like, for a million years, and I've never heard of anyone, 10 minutes post-op, they're being told they might need another surgery, and it kept going on and on and on. That having been said, this particular physician did not ever order physical therapy. He ordered some Epigen ultrasound machine that has a battery. Have you ever heard of that?
I'm familiar with your standard traditional ultrasound, which is like a deep heating modality, but I'm not familiar with this. And it's like anybody, there's always something new coming out.
Well, this was last year.
Okay.
And the gentleman just went back to work part-time a few months ago. And as I said, in the very beginning, he said physical therapy was imperative. He never ordered it. And instead, he ordered this Epigen ultrasound type of a thing that wraps around his ankle.
Okay.
He opted against the second surgery because he wasn't in pain. He was walking around functioning and moving.
Mm-hmm.
The individual is 65 years old.
Okay.
And he said the doctor insisted.
What's the question here?
All right, the question is, should he have gotten physical therapy or didn't he really need it?
Okay. First of all, I would absolutely need more information to properly judge that. Just answering you over with the limited information you've given me, I could not give you that information. But having said that, whenever you have any kind of surgical procedure or where the limb or any of the limbs can be non-weight-bearing for a period of time,
correct,
or if the joints are being held immobile for any length of time, then you're giving it time for things to start to solidify, maybe joints to wear out, bones to demineralize. It really depends on how long that limb is going to be weight-bearing. So usually after a surgical procedure, a lot of times we may just start off with some passive movements. That means I'd be doing the activity for the person moving their limb, and then we would progress on from that point. Now, what can often happen is you can have fibroses form, you can have adhesions in the soft tissues, you can have scar tissue form, and for that I use a system, tools that are called ASTEM, Augmented Soft Tissue Mobilization. I have special tools that I use which assesses and treats those fibrotic tissues, and we basically break them down if we feel them underneath the tool, and then we stretch the tissues after that so as they heal elongated and flexible.
Okay, so
all right. Thank you so much for your call. We got to move along, Doctor. We're running out of time.
I do want to
go right ahead. You want to?
Yeah, I just want to mention something else. One of the big concerns I have is that I'm getting a lot of patients too late in the game. For example, I had a patient who had what we call an acute lateral shift, and I've had several of them actually. They're not super common, but they do happen, and they're very precarious. This particular individual I have on my website at proptrehab.com on my testimonial site, which you can actually review different patients that have been videotaped during their treatment session. I've got a lot of testimonials on there from even from physicians. This individual came in and he was basically crooked. Now, this was not structural. This is not something he had for a long time. This happened suddenly from lifting a 2x4 off the ground. And he was in a very precarious position because his spinal disc was ready to blow, basically. Now, his process was to have to go to a primary care physician. Then they wanted to set him up for diagnostic studies. And then they wanted to, you know, all this stuff takes time. And to be quite frank with you, I don't need a diagnostic study to know what this guy needs. He's teetering on blowing a disc in his spine. The first thing that needs to be done with a person like that is to correct that lateral shift. And then surprisingly, a lot of people don't know how to do that. I know how to do it. I've been doing this for over 20 years now. And this is one of the things I treat very well. And on my website, you can actually see how we were able to treat him within 3 days and have him completely normalized. Now, had he gone through the traditional system, he could have just twisted the wrong way or bent the wrong way, and he would have blown his disc. That's not the first time that kind of thing happened. If you have pain in your leg from your back, you know, do I need you to go get an MRI to say, yeah, you have a disc problem? I mean, that's kind of a waste of time. I'd rather get in there and try to get those symptoms out of your leg. If I can't get the symptoms out of your leg and nothing I do helps, that's your cue to go ahead and have a diagnostic. I refer them out to a physician to consult. So things are a little bit backwards. And we definitely need to do something about getting people with orthopedic problems to the physical therapist right away and not to waste any time.
All right. And people can get in touch with you. They can give you a call at your office if they'd like to consult with you.
Correct.
That number?
In North Cape May, I can be reached at 609-884-9800. That's 609-884-9800. One thing I do want to mention is that, unlike a lot of facilities, we have great secretarial staff, a business manager. My wife is my business manager, Anastasia. She's terrific. She actually, and Pam is terrific. And they actually go in and call the insurance company. They verify your insurance. They get everything set up for you to minimize your efforts.
And by the way, you can reach online your web address.
That's www.proptrehab.com. That's proptrehab, proptrehab.com. I especially would like people to check out the testimonial site.
Right, and you do not limit your treatment session to just 45 or 60 minutes. You take more time.
Oh, no, it's whatever the person needs. That's all there is to it. I don't care how many bodies are in the place. I enjoy the company.
Really. We'll have to do this again. We're running out of time. We're pretty tight for time here this morning, but, Doctor, we'll have to do it again. Thanks. Good to see you
again. Yeah, it's great to see you again.
All right, and if I need to rehab, I should be in rehab probably. We'll be back.
News Talk 1400 WOND.